happy, Luca. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
At the bottom of the stairs is an area connected to the sewers. This seems your most likely escape route.
You just keep eating. Let Andy eat first. Eat some apples.
Among the treasures you claimed is the great sword of the hero Javelin.
Sweet, what's this? Fire.
You succeeded in acquiring intel on the underground fortress. This job will be completed once you report to Count Dean.
First of all,
what troubles you, my child?
Whoa, there's a lot.
Allow this heart to beat again. Quench their thirst. Lead the wandering soul back. Reverse death. And awaken them.
This is Sephiroth, at least.
Allow this heart to beat again. Quench their thirst. Lead the wandering soul back. Reverse death. And awaken them. Allow this heart to beat again. Quench their thirst. Lead the wandering soul back. Reverse death. And awaken them. Voice makes it difficult for you to discern if he's even speaking your language.
Ah, the scary old man.
You can give him a coin if you feel pity for him. Of course, you're free to walk away as well. He doesn't even acknowledge the coin. He mutters over and over. You probably won't be able to communicate with him. No matter how long you strain your concentration.
Afnan Khan is part of Andy's party. Oh look, it's Sephiroth and Andy Rain. They both look alike. Let's see. not as strong.
May I help you? What would you like?
Thank you. Let's check our skills.
You're back.
You report everything you learned to Count Deaton. Unfortunately, you also mentioned the hero's legendary sword. Naturally, he demands the great sword, but at least he's in a good mood now. He thought you'd just flee, but you didn't. It seems that he thinks much more highly of you now. Deaton confides in you some of the problems in the castle. Once the king went missing, the prime minister began recommending the Archduke MacNeil of Bulgar to the throne. Bulgar is an aggressive nation to the north. MacNeil is related to the king of Highland and has a legal claim to the throne. Count Deaton claims that MacNeil has been rallying nobles in Highland to support his claim to the throne. That's why Deaton hired Tommit to steal the scepter. He says that Tommit is extremely trustworthy, so long as he is paid. Suddenly, the Prime Minister and the Princess appear. It seems you are being watched. The Count glowers and departs. The Prime Minister warns you not to involve yourself any further. The Princess, as usual, looks back with blank eyes. Since you completed the job at the castle, you return to the Adventurers Guild to tell them what transpired.
I just been there a while ago.
Roland also happens to be here to report on a job. However, Samuel is not here. Roland is waiting for him to return. Roland thinks that he just missed him and asks you to track down the Guildmaster and bring him back. look for Salma, the guildmaster. He should be somewhere in town.
Yeah, you're wondering how did I know.
What troubles you, my child?
Like I said, I played this before, but I don't remember everything.
You stand before the goddess statues, Jula, Althena, and Vernus. These statues have all crumbled. Texts say the goddesses sacrificed themselves to defeat a dragon, which caused their likenesses to degrade as well. Althena, the one in the center, is the goddess of compassion, battle, and odyssey, making her popular with adventurers. If your party falls during your adventure, a prayer to Althena and a tithing of your money will resurrect the party. If you are repeatedly depending on her grace, the amount you must offer for her services will continually increase. A giant man in armor finishes his prayers and turns around. His pensive expression quickly turns fierce as he sees you. He tells you that he was praying because he has sent many friends to look for the king, but they haven't found the slightest clue. When you ask to help, Samuel just nods and hands you a request form. It's the same request the temple gave you. In a remote region, marriageable girls are disappearing. One by one.
Of course, this thing.
The catacombs are believed to be linked somehow. As you leave the temple, a ragged old man slumped in the road calls out to you in a gravelly voice. His raspy voice makes it difficult for you to discern if he's even speaking your language. You can give him a coin if you feel pity for him. Of course, you're free to walk away as well. He doesn't even acknowledge the coin. He mutters over and over. You probably won't be able to communicate with him. No matter how long you strain your concentration. To solve the mystery of the disappearances, you head to the catacombs, where the villagers fear to tread.
Why not? Let's go. Ah, yes.
In the catacombs, there come dark white bones as strewn above the ground, as far as the eye can see. The sheer number of the deceased is the only indication of that. A strange knight stumbles out of the darkness towards you. You surmise that he is not of this world. The knight is muttering to himself, as if in a daze. If I end my own life, they can no longer sacrifice me. When you move closer, the knight extends his hand. He's holding a scroll. When you accept it, the knight disappears. The path ahead of you is connected to the ruins of the castle colloquially called the Castle of the Dead. In olden times, whenever a girl disappeared, the locals would say she'd been called to the Castle of the Dead. Because ghosts are incorporeal, they are completely immune to physical attacks. Your weakness is light. Torchlight will drive them off. Girl, you must protect
her. Cool, you can actually turn stuff into amazing.
You saved a village girl. You must protect her now.
Thank you.
Protect her now. Protect the village girl. If she's bitten by the others, she will become a vampire as well. In your hands is the bloody scroll that the Ghost Knight had given you. Village girls' disappearances. Obtain your reward at the guild.
First of all,
what troubles you, my child? Allow this. As you leave the temple, a ragged old man slumped in the road calls out to you in a gravelly voice. His raspy voice makes it difficult for you to discern if he's even speaking your language. You can give him a coin if you feel pity for him. Of course, you're free to walk away as well. He doesn't even acknowledge the coin. Why do you not mind, Rashi? He mutters, over and over. You probably won't be able to communicate with him, no matter how long you strain your concentration.
Well,